Given the following system, x double dot plus 3 times x dot minus 2 times x is equal to u of t, and we want to put this in the state space form. Now, in order to put this in the state space form, we have to follow the state space format, which is x dot, which is a vector of all of our x dots, is equal to a times x plus b times u of t, where here a, this is going to be our Jacobian matrix, which will hold all of the important information in our system. And b times u of t, well, that's going to be the external effects on the system. Sweet. So now, the next step that we have to do is we have to define our x values. Now, the question I always get is, what should my x values be, and how many should I have? And those are both great questions. What I always like to tell people is go throughout your system and sum up the number of variables that you have. So in this case, we're not going to sum up u of t because u of t would count as an external effect. So we can neglect that. So that pretty much just leaves us with x. And then with x, it has a highest order derivative of 2. So you're going to go with every single variable one by one, and you're going to sum up the highest order derivative of each. So in this case, since x has a highest order derivative of 2, and x is the only variable that we have, we'll have only 2 x variables. So we can define those as, so we say let x1, x2, because we're going to have 2, and we can say x1 will be x, and x2 is going to be x dot. Now, the reason that we're not defining one of these to be x double dot is because that'll make our life a lot harder. And the whole reason we're doing the state space form is to find out information about the matrix in a more easier way than using x double dot. So if we were to define one of these as x double dot, that would kind of contradict the entire process. So once we have those, what we can do is we can then sub this back into our original equation for the system. So we said that x of 2 is going to be equal to x dot. So x double dot would then be x 2 dot. And then we have plus 3 x dot, or 3 x 2. And then we have minus 2 times x, or minus 2 times x 1. And then we'll set this equal to u of t. So now the next step that we want to do is we want to write out all of the equations for our system. And you might be like, wait, hold up. What are you talking about? We have one equation up here. We only have one equation. Well, in this case, since we have two variables, we actually have to have two equations for our state space form to work, which this one is not too bad because we can basically use the relation between x1 and x2 because we know that x1 dot is going to be equal to x2. See, not so bad. Then for the next part, what we can do is we have to write out our x2 dot equation. So we have that already up here. So we pretty much just need to move all our variables off to one side and just isolate x2. So in this case, what we're left with is 2x1 minus 3 times x2 plus u of t. And now we are actually ready to put this into our state space form. So the first part that we had was our x dots, our vector of x dots, right? So we can write this out as x1 dot and x2 dot. And this is going to be equal to our Jacobian matrix, right? Well, with the Jacobian matrix, this is essentially just matrix multiplication. So we can take out our x1s and our x2 from our essentially two equations up here. So for the first spot, that will be with our x1. So do we have any x1s in our first equation for x1 dot? And that would be no. But in this case, we do have an x2, so then we'll put a 1 right there. We're basically taking, you can imagine, the coefficients from our two equations, and then we're putting them into our Jacobian matrix. So I'll just write out our x vectors here, because that might make things a little bit easier, because we'll essentially have x1 times 0 plus x2 times 1, and then we get our first equation, right? Now for our second equation, for our x's, so we have 2 times x1, so we'll take that coefficient and we'll have 2. And then for the next one, so we have minus 3 x2, so we get minus 3. And then for the u, that's where our b vector comes in. So we'll essentially have plus, oh, there's a vector, there we go. And then for the first one, so we have no u, right? So that would be a coefficient of 0, but in our second equation, we have 1 u. So that'd be a coefficient of 1. And then we multiply that by u of t. And then we have our state space form. So that's pretty much it. Now, the reason that we can do this with our coefficients here is because this is a linear system. Now, I probably should mention this because once we get into nonlinear systems, we actually have to follow a different format for our Jacobian matrix, where we have to take the partial derivatives of each of our two x dot equations here, and we have to essentially take the partial derivative with respect to x1 and x2. And that's actually how we form our Jacobian matrix. So we'll get into that a lot more in different examples, but for now, we did it.